and seven Spanish angels took another angel home.
Hey, I'm Willie Nelson, and you're watching Hemp Rock TV.
We don't run, and we don't compromise. We don't quit, we never do.
Attention, Michigan veterans. I am S. Sergeant Tony Vance, Senior Advisor for Veterans for Medical Cannabis Access. We are working with the state legislature to create a program to help veterans pay for their medical cannabis needs. We need your help. Contact me at 517-224-9037. Don't wait. Come help us.
Hi, I'm Willie Nelson, and the Willie Nelson Teapot Party and I endorse Veterans for Medical Cannabis Access.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Master Sergeant Tony Vance, the voice of Freedom's Voice. We're going to talk about Fort Bragg. 109 soldiers assigned to Fort Bragg died in 2020 and 2021. Dozens have lost their lives there to drug overdoses, as reported in the Rolling Stone magazine. And what it points out to, and what it looks like, is that these guys are doing hard drugs because it's easier to get away with it than if they were doing cannabis. The guy can do a little cocaine on a Friday. It's out of his system by Sunday evening. P-test on Monday, he's good to go. But if he uses cannabis, he can stay in his system for a couple of weeks. If he's an everyday user, stay in there for 30 days. So you got to ask yourself, why are they doing hard drugs? Well, I think it's really just simple. It's easier to get away with, but it has a cost. And that cost is addiction to hard drugs. And there you are, bang. And then you're getting your regular, you know, you're getting your regular hard drugs. And then somebody says, well, you know, I got these pills, but they're okay. And then they're laced with fentanyl, and we have dead people. You know, we've been through this before. You know, I mean, there were 30 of these guys, these overdoses right at the start of 2020. And like I said, we've been here before. Nixon's war on drugs was the same crap. And I was in Germany at the time. Got there in 1970. Everybody's smoking hash. I know I've told this story before, but got there in 1970. Everybody's smoking hash. It was a normal thing. Nobody said nothing about it. Marijuana had been, the marijuana law had been declared unconstitutional in 1969. They had just come out with the Controlled Substances Act, putting marijuana temporarily in Schedule I until the Schaefer Commission came out with its report, Drugs in America. And when they did come out with their report, Drugs in America, they said that marijuana should be decriminalized and that drugs were a medical problem and not a criminal problem. And Nixon declared the war on drugs. And we know now that it was all a political scam to harass his political enemies. But I'm not going to go through the whole thing now. You've heard it before, I'm sure. But a good example of what happened was in 1972, when Nixon declared the war on drugs, they came up the Autobahn, all the air bases, and busted everybody. There was no smoke to be had anywhere. And I was in the barracks looking around about 10 days after all of that had happened. And the guys were in one of the guys' rooms in there snorting heroin. And next thing you know, Simbach Air Base, along with all the other military bases in Germany, had a heroin problem. They pushed everybody to hard drugs. And the result was a lot of guys getting addicted. I was addicted for about 6 months. Me and another guy locked ourselves up in the apartment for 4 days. And when we come out, there was no more hard drugs. Smoked a lot of hash over that weekend, but a lot of guys got addicted. And in the process of that, you know, getting in trouble, losing their careers, losing their freedom. And it continued in 1980 when I went to Germany. I told all my guys, do not cross the border with anything. You will regret it. And one guy didn't listen, got busted with 100 grams of hash coming back from Amsterdam at the border and went to jail. Now, the sad thing behind all this is we know by 1993 it was all a scam. The military needs to change. Now, not later. They need to authorize the use of cannabis in off-duty time to active duty military. You'll benefit their endocannabinoid systems, which are starving for the right cannabinoids, which are only in marijuana. You'll give them a drug that can't hurt them or kill them or get them addicted. It just ain't. You say, oh, he's addicted to marijuana. You just stop. Then that's not a problem. Anyway, you'll cut down on your overdose and your hard drug problem, and you'll be doing the right thing. Allow active duty soldiers the use of cannabis in their off-duty hours. If you want to do it that way, say if they're in a legal state. And stop making things worse. You're making things worse. Prohibition doesn't work. It didn't work with alcohol, and it's not worked with drugs. You have not won the war on drugs. The drugs have won. Actually, if you want to think about it, freedom won. The prohibition of anything is a authoritarian gig. Now, in the 90s, Portugal went to harm reduction while we doubled down on putting people in jail and screwing up their lives. Okay? We need to, first of all, marijuana should be decriminalized, and drugs, we need to set up a harm reduction system for doing drugs. There was a 67% drop in hard drug use in Portugal when they went to harm reduction, as opposed to doubling down on prohibition. Why can't we learn from other countries what the hell to do with some of these policies? It's time for the military to allow the use of cannabis for active duty during off-duty time. You'll be treating their PTSD. Like I said, beefing up their endocannabinoid systems, which is going to make them healthier. Not going to knock them out and have them driving off the side of the road or falling down or overdosing and dying, and you walk in their room in the barracks, and there's two guys laying there dead on the doornail. Because they used the illegal, dangerous drugs, as opposed to what should be legal cannabis. It saved my life. By the time, the problem with me was, by the time I'd been turned on to marijuana and realized it was the medicine I should be using for whatever the hell was wrong with me, I didn't know. I was an alcoholic. And it took me a long time to get over that. But I finally did. We need to allow active duty use of cannabis in off-duty hours. Boom. Cancer, I'm still fighting the cancer. It hasn't got any worse, but it ain't got any better. Have a good time. Memorial Day is coming up. Mother Day first, then Memorial Day. Remember and remember. See you next time.
Hi, I'm Willie Nelson, and the Willie Nelson Teapot Party and I endorse Veterans for Medical Cannabis Access.
You throw me up and smoke me when I die.
Hey, I'm Willie Nelson, and you're watching Hemp Rock TV.